It is that time, my friends. Happy Saturday, or Sunday, depending on where in the world you live. Let's see. Live chat. We're good. I can actually bring you in a little bit closer.
Just so those lights are not
annoying. Let's see, how's that? A little bit better. We have a lot to talk about today. We have a lot of projects going on, and I'm filling in the fish, which is exciting. I literally spent like the last 2 hours setting up for this. So, wish me luck. Okay, today we're gonna play with some alcohol inks, which is not something I do very often, but I do use them every once in a while. But because I posted one of my pieces recently, which is this one, and it actually just sold, which is very exciting for me.
It's very, very pretty. Lots of depth and stuff.
So because people liked it a lot, I was like, you know what? I haven't done a video with alcohol inks, so let me go over the whole science of it with you guys. All right. I don't like using the silicone molds directly on a table without making sure that they're level, because you're going to end up lopsided, obviously. So I have this piece of wood that I'm going to use to level it out. The level, a real level, is your best friend. Don't go by the app. I've seen people do it. It fails. Sometimes using sticks works much better than doubling up on the cups. If you're here and you're subscribed and you have a channel, say hello. All right, that's good. Nice and even. Always clean them, like even if you've cleaned them in the past and they've just kind of been sitting around even for an hour or so, always clean them and make sure that there's nothing on the bottom. Come on. I do want to take a minute and say that major prayers go out to everybody that's affected by the hurricane right now, because we get them every single year and they are no joke, like no joke at all. So we keep watching on TV what's going on. I have friends that live in North Carolina and I'm mega worried about them.
Hello, friends.
Funny. I kind of got to look at the tablet. By the way, I have a full-on cold right now, but I didn't want to bail out on you guys, so I showed up. Yeah, that tablet thing was quite funny. I don't think she really fully understood what being live on YouTube means and the whole point of like talking to people and responding questions. I don't know if she thought maybe I was talking to myself. Not sure. Although it feels sometimes like I'm talking to myself. All right. So first, before I get started, I want to talk about resin and the different kinds of resin. I used to use Promarine, okay? I used it a lot when I first started, for like once in months. Oh, I'm sorry. Your bad reception or my bad reception? The thing about Promarine is, as you can even see in the bottle right now, like, it will yellow. It's going to yellow over time, and it does not take a long time for it to yellow. So if you do use this in your artwork, I suggest only using it when you're doing full-on color, meaning there's no clear spots in whatever you're making with it. Because, prime example, when I originally made this, it was completely clear. And then this is just a few months later, and I'm not sure if you can see, but it's yellow. And it's gonna continue to yellow even more. So Promarine is a no-go for doing alcohol inks or for doing anything that has clear in it. I no longer work with it at all. But I know it's the cheapest one. So if you're a beginner and you're just starting out, use it till you figure out what you're doing and, you know, you get more comfortable with working with resin. But as soon as you get to the point where, you know, you want perfection, I would suggest going up to art coat, and then from that going up to stone coats, because that's the best. So talking about art coat, I'm gonna do a little science-y thing right now, because I have realized that in some pieces, like I used to use a lot of art coat when I used to do alcohol ink projects, and I think they have a very different viscosity, because with art resin, they just seem to, with art resin, they just seem to like push more through the resin, versus with stone coats resin, I think it's a little thicker and it doesn't fully penetrate all the way through. So I don't know, we're gonna see, we're gonna make both. And then tomorrow when they're dry, we're gonna see which one let the color go all the way through the most. Might as well level this out while we're waiting for more people to come in. I didn't have another piece of wood, so I'm just using a canvas that I have, a wood canvas, to level it out. It still has the plastic on it, so if I get any resin on it, I can still, you know, take it off and reuse it. Hello, Danny and Jade. We are making all kinds of stuff. It's exciting. I have a ton of projects going on today. We are doing alcohol inks, we are filling in the fish, and then we are doing resin painting, because, I don't know, I just wanted to do it all. So we're going to start with the alcohol inks and then move on to the fish and so on. Thank you guys so much for being here. Don't forget to hit that thumbs up button. Gold, right there. I do want to show you some. Actually, you know what? I'll hold it for a little bit later. Again, make sure you wipe this really good. I have dogs, so dog hair gets in everything. Hey, Jojo. How are you, babe? Happy Sunday to you. We're doing lots of stuff today. Lots and lots of projects. But I'm excited. Alright, so first I'm going to start with the stone coat one, and then we're going to go to the art coat one. And like I said, once they're both dry, I will show you guys the difference of how the alcohol inks react to it. As far as alcohol inks, I use this brand. And the reason why I use this brand is because because I've tried other brands and there's a huge difference in how it affects your painting. So let me explain that a little further.
This is the tip of the pinata color. See how it's shaped? This is made by someone else. And see how that's shaped? What this means is when you're using this one,
it literally pushes the color through so like heavy and so much that you end up with the other side of your painting looking splotchy. Instead of like that three-dimensional thing, you just see like dots. So I'm not a fan of this. I stick to pinata if you're gonna do anything with inks. Inks will fade over time. I'm not fully sure how long it takes to fade. I've made a lot of pieces, a lot of my plaques, and they're still good. I mean, again, choose your resin wisely when you're doing this, but this one, for example, this one was made a long time ago and it's still great. All right, so let's get started. We're doing 16 ounces. When you're working with inks, you don't want to have a very thin layer of resin because it needs something to go through, like it needs depth in order to get that really, really depthy look. So make sure you're like, I don't know, with mine, they're like a half an inch. So this is the stone coat one. We're doing 16 ounces. So again, if you do choose to use Promarine, it's great for beginners. It's what I used for the longest time till I figured out the issues with it. But as long as you got full color, you should be all right.
Hi, Terry. Welcome, welcome.
I always feel like when you guys like check in and start saying hi, you guys are just gonna like walk through my door and just like sit down. It would be so great. So I'm excited though. We're filling that fish finally, and you gotta see my redneck ingenuity when it comes to how I prepped it. It's quite funny, but I hope it works. Alrighty, I don't even know what colors I'm gonna do. I chose some earlier, but we'll see. Alright, so let's talk alcohol ink science. Yes, the fish is finally happening. I'm sorry I made you guys wait so long. Alright, so what I've learned from working with it a lot is they are different heaviness or whatever you want to call it. For example, the regular colors are medium weight when it comes to them going down. The white is the heaviest of all, which is why whenever you're doing a 3D painting like this with ink resins, every time you put in a color, you want to follow it with white. So whenever you buy these inks, make sure you buy like a bunch of white too, because you're going to be using it. This is the most thing you're going to use. And then the lightest of them all are your metallics. So your silver and your gold. I have not been able to get them to truly push through. They tend to stick at the top. I actually had a piece I was going to show you and I forgot to grab it, but it will basically stick at the top on the back of your piece and not fully penetrate all the way through to the bottom. So they do have different weights to them, if you will. If my voice sounds funny, it's because I'm sick as hell. I have such a cold and I didn't want to let you guys down and not show up, especially since you guys were excited about all this. So I'm here sounding funny. So if you get sniffles or coughs, I apologize. Yes, absolutely. Dateless. All right. And I'm pretty sure that the art resin has less viscosity versus stone coats resin, because I feel like I got better like results with that when it comes to doing these 3D ink paintings. I have not, Frankie. Actually, maybe I have. I do have this, which kind of pushes it through,
but it also kind of spreads the color a lot, so I don't know that I'm a huge fan of it. It's just clear stuff
that's made to like spread it, and again, I'm no expert. I'm seriously just talking from my own personal experience with working with these things. Alright, I think I'm ready. Are you ready? What are we doing? I think I want to do... I had this one piece that I really like that sold. I no longer have it. That had, like, lines of different colors. So I think we're going to try that with sapphire blue. Oh, okay. Sorry, Michael. Hello. Yeah, I never know. People on YouTube have, like, different names. And so if I don't, like... recognize you right off the rip, that's probably why. So as you're gonna see, hopefully I have enough white for both pieces. This is like my last little bottle. So if I think I don't have enough, I'm not gonna make that second one. Make sure all of your bottles are fully closed, like tightly closed, because I used to store them in like a Ziploc bag, all of them together, and one of them leaked, and that's the reason why they're all looking like doo-doo right now and they're covered in paint. Come on. All right. Blue. Go to town.
Hi, Olympia, Tiff, watch me name and eat.
I gotta bring you guys in. Sorry, I forgot. Because I do want you to see how cool this looks as you're making it. Oh yeah, shaking one of these when the lid is loose, you're gonna be covered. Done that before, for sure. You want to get rid of the majority of the bubbles before you put anything in it. Toothpicks, your best friend, because after you're done with making them, you truly want to keep an eye on them for the next hour or so in case dust or any sort of bugs or dog hair in my case, which is all the time, happen to fly in it, and you have pretty much about an hour to pick them out. And then if it gets a little bit too hard, like as you're picking it out and it leaves an indentation, heat gun and it'll level itself off. Get out of there. There we go. Well, Olympia, since you've never used it, I will teach you how right now. All right, Yeah, let me bring you guys in.
That was a lovely sound. Come on, cooperate. Actually, I think I want to put you right on the table, right above it. There you go. First row seat. How's that? Yes. These are silicone molds. That's the only thing you can pretty much work with when it comes to resin that it won't stick to. They're just cake molds. So if you just go on Amazon and type in cake molds, silicone cake molds, you'll get all of these. So, let the party start. Why is this tip yellow? Hang on 1 second. All right. And as I said, you gotta follow every drop with white. Come on. The white is actually what makes it, what pushes it down, since it's the heaviest of all. But just wait till you see how cool these things move. Is that clear enough, or do you want to be closer? I can probably get you a little bit closer. There you go. How much would I price a piece like this? I personally sold this one for $60. And that included shipping. They're a little bit heavier and take a lot of resin, which is why they're kind of expensive. Just wait till you see how these things move. They're so freaking cool. I love them. I don't think I'm gonna have enough white for that second piece, so we'll see. And what's cool is the back will also, not also, always look completely different than the front. And because I love you guys very much, I actually made two pieces last night so that you guys can see a finished product and not have to wait till I put it on Facebook tomorrow. Because I love you guys. It's a little bit time consuming, but where's that yellow? I do have yellow. It's just like so super cool to watch them like move around and do their thing. I was obsessed with this when I first started working with resin. Sorry if I'm not talking too much, I'm concentrating. I wish I had that piece that I'm talking about that I sold. It was so awesome. I'm pretty sure I put a picture of it on Facebook though. What did I do next? I think it was orange. Pretty sure. Inks are super cool to work with. They really are. But you technically, as much as you think you're in control of how it turns out, it's out of your control because it keeps moving over the course of like I don't know, the next 4 hours or so. So if you take a picture of it when you're first done with it, it's gonna look completely different 4 hours later. It does. It really does move. So the white, if you missed it in the beginning, we're using the white to push the color through the resin since the white is the heaviest one. Damn it, I lost my track of what I was, I think it was this one. I'm definitely not gonna have enough white for the second piece, I mean. Come on, don't tell me you're out already. Oh no. Really? All right, hang on 1 second. Guess what we're gonna have to do? We're gonna have to use that white that I was talking crap about earlier. Is this sapphire or Baja? Baja. See how this white doesn't spread? And how it like goes, shoots straight down? That's what I was trying to explain earlier, that it doesn't spread like the other does. It's super, super heavy, and then you end up with white spots on the bottom, but it's all I got right now, so we're gonna roll with it. Cool movement, huh? And then when the colors touch each other, obviously they turn into other colors as well. I think I'm gonna stop there and just kind of let it do its thing. Why so many layers? Because you're using the weight of themselves to push it through. If you just do one layer, it's gonna end up looking like a flat image. So in order to get it to go all the way through the thickness of the resin, you need all those layers and you need all that white. It's cool to watch, though. It's totally gonna change over time. It's slowly moving. So like I said, although alcohol inks kind of stop the bubbling process for the most part, they don't bubble up so much. Keep an eye on it for the next hour or so. Try to pick stuff out as it lands in it, and then if you do see bubbles, heat gun it. But we'll see what this looks like tomorrow. Sorry about all that movement. Come on, cooperate. I want to show you a couple things first before we move on to the next thing. Why is this not working? Thank you. There we go. Holy moly.
So I'm gonna move this over here. I already made sure that those were level and let it do its thing. Like I said, it's gonna keep moving and doing stuff over the next few hours. Because I don't have enough white, I don't think I'm even gonna attempt to do that second one. I'll probably do it on a different show with the art coat. So we're gonna put this aside. But I do wanna show you guys, since you're not gonna know what that looks like right now, I do wanna show you guys what I made last night. So you can see a final project.
Okay, so the pieces I made last night were this one. That's the backside, so that's where we're putting the colors in. And then this is the front. You're not gonna have too much clarity, but I promise I will put pictures of it. I'm pretty in love with it myself. And then I made this one. Again, this is the backside. This is where your drips are going in. And then this is the front side. It's all 3D and cool looking. Looks like an underwater scene. And this one, I didn't make it last night. I made it a long time ago. And I'm not really happy with how it came out, but bam. There he is. Little R2-D2 action. I'm gonna do another attempt at it. I just wasn't happy with how much of the white came through. So those are that. They're all for sale. You guys ready to move on to that fish? The famous fish. Oh, also, when you do make these and when you're selling them, I recommend investing in these. They're little plastic, holder thingies so that your pieces, we'll just use this one as an example, can be, come on, displayed nicely. So, definitely recommend these. You can buy them on Amazon. They're not expensive. All right. Let me bring you up a little higher.
JoJo's excited for Spike. Wait till you guys see my redneck ingenuity when it came to putting that together today. Let me just clean this up real quick. This is like the most annoying part, sorry. Like, I do have one fluid painting I would like to do. Hopefully you guys can stick around for that. Because I'm going to be using Stone Coat's red base coat for the very first time. I haven't used it yet. It looks like I have. That was just from shipping. Including me. Ronnie, I'll get on that as long as he tells me what colors he wants or what effect he wants in them. Y'all ready for this? Check out what I did. So, because you can't use just like a wood backing, I don't know if you can see me there. Because you can't use a regular wood backing to support what you're pouring into because it would stick to the wood behind it, you have to use parchment paper, like for anything. If you see it on my tables, I use it all the time. I do have garbage bags, like black regular giant garbage bags underneath, but garbage bags are expensive. And I used to go through them like crazy in the beginning, and I'm like, there's gotta be an easier way than this. And parchment paper would not stick to resin. So it's amazeballs. So you can make a mess and then just take it and toss it and replace it. So what I did is I got a piece of wood from Lowe's, which fits right in between. I hope you can see this. It fits right in between the two edges of this. I wrapped it in parchment paper and then I clamped it down with six clamps. And I also took some of those stir sticks and I wrapped them in paper towel, and the reason for that is because I didn't want the indentations of these to ruin my painting. So that's what we're working with. It ain't classy, but hopefully it works. That's funny, Joe. All right. So, I originally said I was gonna make him silver. But my biggest fear is that the silver is going to be very dark, and my whole point of it is that the glow-in-the-dark powder can really truly glow in the dark at night, and I didn't want the silver to dim that down at all. So we are still using silver, but like the tiniest little bit of platinum by Just Resin. But my main thing I'm going to use is Violet Pearl by Artisu as my powder. And then I bought a whole bunch of glow-in-the-dark powders, and today I did a test on them. Like, I put a bunch of light on all of them, and then I took them in a dark room and I checked out which one glows the most. And the one that glows the most out of all of these is the neutral green. This is Art and Glow, by the way. So that's what we're going with. That one's like the brightest. Okay, so I guess we might as well use some of this since we're doing it. That might be a bit much. Hang on, let me think. I don't know, how many ounces do you think that would be? I don't want to make it flush. So, let's see. I think 8 ounces would be plenty. So that's 4. And we're going to do 4 more. Wait, that's 6 ounces. Darn it. Science is hard. All right, we're at 4. That's funny, Dateless. You can always rewatch it. But yeah, like I said, with alcohol ice, get extra white. It's what you're using to push it down. And if you try to use silvers and golds and metallics and stuff like that, they're gonna stay on the top. They're just not heavy enough. No matter how much you try to push it down, they don't really come through, which is kind of annoying. But if you only want to look at the one side that has the silver on it, then it's fine. Hopefully I have enough time to get everything done, because I still have another fluid piece, because I'm excited about using that red. trying to compensate for a couple of times I bailed out on you guys. Plus, I won't be here on the Saturday of my birthday because, you know, party and stuff. But my last day of work is November 2nd. And after that, I will definitely be going live a lot more since I'm going to be doing this full time. And then I can show you guys all kinds of stuff. For those of you that follow my page and participate in Show Me Your Art Thursdays, can I just tell you, you guys are so talented. Like, I love that day. Absolutely love it. Some of the things you guys do, whether it's resin, whether it's painting, whether it's whatever, I'm blown away. And I just thank you guys for participating. Again, I don't want to make it flush with this. I just kind of want it to be sunk in a little bit so it has more of a 3D effect. And then I'll probably do a flood coat somehow after everything is done. And I'll definitely take pictures like daytime and then nighttime so you guys can see if it worked out or not. It's like extra bubbly today. Alright, so we're doing White Pearl Pigment Powder by Artisu. Which is like the main color. The reason why I like it is because it's white with like a purple undertone. It's like really cool. Like when the light hits it, it goes from white to like purple. Your piece is amazing, Jojo. I saw it in the pictures and in the video you sent me, and it looks great. I don't know if I can show you guys if the lighting is good enough to see what I'm really talking about when I say white and purple. Can't see it in the camera. See that purple shade right there? Alright. Now we are gonna put a little tiny bit of just resin's platinum and see what happens. Total experiment here. But since it's my piece, I feel like I can go nuts with it. Spike is made out of pieces of wood. There's, I think, three pieces of wood that are glued together. And then they have the two pieces in the back to keep it all together. And then it wasn't made by me. Like, I got it already like that. But then they went in with a router and cut up the shape. So you can make it from any piece of wood. Just buy a solid piece of wood and then route out whatever you would like it to be. And then I went in and I taped everything off on the inside, like where the holes are and the edges. And then I did this top layer and then I let it dry for, I don't know, it's been a couple weeks. And now I'm doing the inside. All right, we just want a little tiny bit. We don't want you to take over. see if that's enough. Or if we need more. That silver actually acts like made the purple be more intense. That's pretty cool though. Yes, Ronnie. There you go. Old palettes. But you can do it out of a solid piece of wood as well. Home Depot, Lowe's, anything like that. I'm liking this. I don't know. Should I go any darker?
Let's see. Should I go darker than that? Or is that good?
Because I still have to add the glow and the dark stuff. Oh, cool, Terry. I can't wait to see what you make. I think that's good, right? Color-wise? Because it's going to change again when I put the other powder in it. I'm messy. Okay. Yeah, Jojo, I ended up... Prior to putting the piece of wood on the back that I told you about, I actually had to sand the whole entire back because some of the resin on the top leaked through. And so it wasn't even, and I was really afraid that when I clamp down this other piece, it's going to have spots that it's going to seep out through. So I did want to tell you guys, I bought this cool sander by Black & Decker. It was cheap, and it was amazing. It literally, everything was flush. It took me 2 minutes. And then you can buy a box of all of the sanding papers. You get 120 and all kinds of different grits. It's amazeballs. The one that I used today was P40 grit because, you know, wood and resin and you wanted something a lot rougher than when you're sanding the front of a painting. But yeah, that thing, I felt so fancy. I was like, look at me go. Dateless, basically, like I said, what it's making it a mold, quote-unquote, right now, is the fact that I taped that piece of wood behind it, as you can see it, so that we have something to pour on. And if you missed it, I used parchment paper because resin will not stick to it. So then I'm able to just take it off and sand it flush and should be good. All right, I'm gonna go a little bit nuts with this because I don't know how much it takes for it to truly glow. So, we want it to like glow so you can see it from the moon. I just don't know how much the other pigments are gonna dim it down, so that's why I'm going a little overboard. Open. Yeah, I was a little disappointed because when I shined my light and tested those other colors before, the blue is really not that crazy bright, and then the pink and the purple is like the least punchy, which kind of disappointed me a little bit. Hopefully this is enough. If not, I could always just leave it and then clear coat on top of it to give it a little bit more depth. But if you missed the making of the top of it, I was explaining how I didn't want to make it any of the same colors that are on the top because I wanted it to stand out. So that's why we're going with something completely different in it. It's not true to the color of a swordfish, but nobody's gonna see it but me. Alright. Cross your fingers. We're going in. If it's not enough, I'll mix more. Oh crap, I forgot to bring you guys in.
All these things, I need an assistant.
Sorry. That's cool. And that's definitely enough resin. So that was 8 ounces total. And it's got like different lines and stuff in it where you can see either the silver or the purple or the glow in the dark. Hey, Adrian. How are you, dear? Thank you for showing up. So we finally filled in the fish. It's a done deal. If you missed the alcoholing process earlier, you can just rewatch it later. Before I move on with it to another piece because I want to make sure all the bubbles are out. He sure does. It looks kind of silvery. I'm happy with it. You can definitely tell what it is and it sticks out. So that's exciting. Adrian, you missed my description of my redneck ingenuity when it came to how I made that happen. Come on already. Jesus Christ, this thing hates me. Can I put an eye on him? Probably, like later. But swordfish have, well actually Ron, you're the one that asked the question. You're the one that told me that swordfish have like super giant eyeballs. So I don't know how I would make it accurate, but I can try. I don't know. First we'll have to do the test and see if he actually glows in the dark, which would be amazing. Definitely happy with the amount of resin and that it still has that. All right, we're gonna put you go night night and you be good. It weighs a ton right now with that other piece behind it. All right, picture or one more piece? Why am I pushing it? Alright, this is just spray painted with Rust-Oleum white, red, black, red, and white. I'm making a mess, guys. Terry thinks. Oh, you guys are so awesome. Thank you. I didn't want to keep you here forever, but I just had all these things I wanted to do and show you. Hit that thumbs up if you haven't, please, for me. That'd be great. Alrighty. So, I kind of have a plan. You're looking at it. We'll see what happens. I'm just excited to use the red from Stone Coat because I haven't used it yet. I also really want to use the green because I heard it's awesome. I have it. I literally have all of their colors. I just haven't gotten a chance to use all of them yet. Thank you, Terry. Hopefully it comes out good. So, let's see. I've got black base tint, Stone Coat, white base tint, Stone Coat, red base tint, Stone Coat. And then, just for like a pop, depending on how we're feeling about it, after I did those three, I figured I could put in some saffron by Just Resin and some sparkly yellow powder by Artisu. But we'll see. We'll play it by ear. And as soon as I'm done with all this, my butt is going right back to bed because I feel like doo-doo. I just woke up yesterday morning full on cold, like no warning, nothing. I can't wait till I'm done with work and then I can do a lot more of these lives. Because I mean, I make the pieces anyway, and it would just be cooler if I make them along with you guys. I would totally love to be able to make a river table, but I truly do not have the space or the tools for it. Oh, I did have somebody mention that they wanted to incorporate alcohol inks in a river table. And I promised I would explain something. See how these things come out different on one side versus the other? Hang on. Like I was saying earlier, you would have to decide which part you would like to be the top of the table since they look completely different. So if you wanted this as the top of your table, the one that looks like underwater kinda, you would have to build your table upside down basically. Just if you want like that movement, because the back always looks like you have a lot of cool colors, but it always looks flat. Where the other one is really punchy. Yeah, I did see that about the tape. Terry, I just don't have any. And I didn't want to hold out any longer on filling up the fish. Hopefully he comes out good.
they do fade, Olympia, which is why I don't work with, alcoholics do fade over time, which is why I don't work with them very often. But as long as you have a really good resin, I know you weren't here in the beginning, Olympia. I was talking about pro-marine resin and how it absolutely, very quickly yellows. When I first made this piece, it was clear. And
maybe like not even a month later, it's, I don't know if you can tell how yellow it really is, but it's very yellow. So that will also affect how fast your inks fade. So if you use it in stone coat or art resin, they should last a lot longer.
Alright. Don't really know what I'm going for here. Maybe some like fire effects. I don't really have a plan, but my biggest thing is I just want to see how this red reacts and interacts with everything. I heard good things about it. Both stone coat and art resin are good. Some people happen to be allergic to art resin from what I've heard. I like them both, but I probably prefer stone coat a little bit more than art resin. It's really fluid at first, art resin is, but I feel like the work time is a lot less than stone coat's art resin. I hope so. We'll see what happens. Mix, mix, mix. If you guys ever have any ideas that you would like me to try, or if you happen to sell any of the products and you'd like me to try them on the live, just let me know on my channel. Send me either my channel or on Facebook. Send me a message. I'm Vibrant Expressions 1209. And any cool ideas you guys would like me to try, I'll try them out. I don't like to get boring and do the same thing over and over, hence we're doing three different things today. I wouldn't trust the packing tape that much, Stateless, because I've used it on the side of canvases, and if you don't take it off within probably an hour or two, like, it's a pain in the ass to take off. So I don't know that I would risk it on something like that. Because I mean, aluminum tape works great too, but that's the same thing. If you don't take it off at just the right time, it's stuck in there. But I'll make sure to make a video when I take the clamps off and take the backing off and see how it looks. I'll let you guys know for sure. Alrighty. I think we'll do.
I ran out of paper cups, so we're doing plastic today. What do I got? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Hang on. We're doing about a half a cup of these little ones. I'm using this for just the accent colors, like your yellow and your saffron and the red. I'm gonna go a little bit thicker on the red, a little bit more. And then I'm actually going to save some, just in case I don't have enough. Okie dokes.
me bring you closer. I've never even heard of that, Terry. Acetate? I don't even know what that is. This red sure is pretty though. It's like a very true red. I'm probably putting too much, but oh well. Oh, okay. Gotcha. It's like plexiglass. Man. Ooh, I'm a hot mess today. This saffron, holy smokes, man. It's so amazing. Yeah, silicone is definitely the best when it comes to not sticking to anything. This. Hang on. Ugh. It created like a film on the top. What in the world? Really? This white is completely hardened. That's a first. Stone coat, what's up with that? Let me go grab another one. I'm sorry, guys. Struggle on my show, huh? That's craziness. It's like not completely hard, but it's like silicone textured right now. I don't even know what to think about that. I'm struggling with my glove, y'all. And I'm hearing noises outside, so I'm just curious what that is. Alright, holy smokes, let's do this. Hopefully the black won't be the same. Good thing I had a backup. Thank you for your patience, seriously. That container I've had for probably, I don't know, a month or so, 2 months. But I also have another one that I'm trying to pry open to see if it did the same thing. Because that's very odd. I'm gonna try to do that wave effect, like that selling effect, and I'm gonna try to go white over black and then black over white to see the difference, and then we'll put in the red. See, the black is fine. That's just weird. Yeah, but none of the other colors did that, Joe. This red is so red. I love it. I've always had a hard time finding a pigment that's like blood red. You know what I mean? Like true, true red. You guys are watching, please throw me some thumbs up. That would be cool. I'm excited. Next Saturday, the person that bought Alexander a while back is actually driving all the way down from Ocala to come pick it up. So that's cool. I get to finally meet her in person. This saffron is to die for, seriously. All right, I'm gonna bring you actually even more close now that we're starting so that you can see it. Come on. All right. Going down. I'm going to save a little bit. This is some clear. I just want to see what it does. This is a complete experiment. Like, I haven't done this before. So we will see.
spreading time. This is like my favorite time. And I forgot to double glove. Nice. I'm just kind of using the clear as like a little bit of a divider between the white and the black. Because I'm going to roll them over each other anyway. But just for now. Sorry, I'm so quiet, concentrating. Come on. All right, we'll start with that. Kind of cool that you can still see the red underneath through that clear part. I actually think that clear is stopping it from selling. Black, so lesson learned. No clear if you want cells. All right, we're gonna give up on that idea because I'm not happy with it. So,
all
not liking this so far, but we'll see what happens. Should I cover this black with white so it's symmetrical? Yes, the white, the red, and the black are all stone coat. The yellow is artisu and the saffron is just resin. More like it. Too excited about this one. Thank you. I'm gonna stop before I overdo it. It's not my favorite, but I'll wait and see how I feel about it in the morning. I've done much better. We'll see. Maybe I'll like it tomorrow.
Kind of disappointed, I gotta tell you. Maybe I ruined it with that clear in between. I'll try it again, the same colors, and see what happens. Oh, I'm glad you like it, Dateless. That's not true. Your piece is not a disaster, JoJo. And then the second time you did it, it was even awesomer. But that's all I got, folks. And I hope you learned a lot today. And I'm trying to give you all my tips and tricks and all that stuff. And if you missed the very beginning when we did alcohol inks, I talked all about different resin types, how to properly use alcohol inks. Then I filled in the fish. If you missed any of that, just watch it from the beginning and you will have most of your answers on there. If you don't already follow me on my Facebook page, I'm Vibrant Expressions 1209, and I would love to have you there. Same with Instagram. If you have any ideas that you would like me to try or materials you would like me to try, shoot me a message and I'll try to make it happen. If you have any questions, again, shoot me a message. I try to answer literally every comment, every question, everything on Facebook that you guys throw at me. So I try to stay on top of it as much as possible. But that's all we got. And please don't forget to hit that thumbs up on your way out if you haven't already. Thank you, Terry. Thank you guys, like, all for showing up and for talking to me and for the interest and the support. And it means a ton. And like I said, November 2nd being my last day of work, I will be here a lot more often and we'll do all kinds of cool stuff. So, and because I'm in love with the fish, I'm going to actually get somebody to make me a couple more of those. With like different shapes and stuff, and that way I can actually put them for sale. This one is special to me, so I'm gonna keep it, but that way I can sell a bunch of them. So that's all we got. Bye everyone, I'll see you next Saturday hopefully. And right now I'm gonna clean all this mess up and go to bed because I'm feeling like doo-doo. But thank you for watching. Bye.